I had this conversation the other day with the lovely Brittany Palmer. She's one of the ring girls of the UFC. Anyway, she's a very nice person, and she is fascinated by the 70s and the 60s. And she's a painter, and she makes all these. She's making all these different paintings. And we were having this conversation, like, I'm the same way. When I listen to music, 9 times out of 10, when I'm driving in my car, I'm listening to like some 1970s Zeppelin, or it's some 1970s Allman Brothers, or Lynyrd Skynyrd. That shit to me just resonates. You know, when I listen to old music from like that era, for whatever reason, it just resonates. And I'm trying to figure out, what is it about that time? What is it about the Jimi Hendrix? What is it about Jim Morrison? Was it just because it was the first of that shit? Was it because it was the first of this giant evolutionary breakthrough from
I think it's a combination of a number of things. One is that a lot of people back then thought their music was counted for something. In other words, they thought that their music could actually change something. And a lot of what happens with artists is cynicisms at times have a certain cynical stamp on them. And I think we live in a very cynical time. The notion that nothing you do as an individual, certainly as an artist, could change anything at all, that's very prevalent among artists. So you don't have people who are doing stand-up, for example, to try to break a social norm or shatter a social norm. You certainly don't have a lot of musicians saying, my music is actually going to influence the political atmosphere. Remember, it was after, we had been through in the 70s, we'd just been through and we're going through a terrible war in Vietnam. We were in the Cold War, we'd been through World War II, and everybody had an active memory of that. That shit, life really counted and mattered, and people didn't live as long. And there's this idea that you better hurry up and get through it and make your fucking stamp while you still have an opportunity. Because if you looked around, and let's take 1974, and you looked around at the world, and half the world was living under communist dictatorships, which was essentially slavery. And by the way, there was an arms race called the nuclear arms race between the Soviet Union and the United States, and a lot of people really were like, you know what, we could all fucking just blow up. And there was always that saying that if there is a third world war, I think it was Einstein who said...
He said, I don't know what's going to start the third world war, what weapons will be used, but the fourth world war will be fought with sticks.
But the point is that I think when you live in times of great uncertainty and times of great hope and times of great violence, remember, in this country, we come off a number of assassinations, Martin Luther King, right. Malcolm X, and it goes on and on. I mean, there was this notion that we were in a real battle and a real social battle for our souls, man. You had governments sending young boys off to die in a war. Most people hadn't even heard of that fucking part of the world. And there was this idea that we gotta get in the streets and say something and do something. More importantly, if we do so, shit will change. And people were getting hosed down, and black people didn't have the vote until 1964. It was only 10 years old. So when you think about how extreme things were, when you get a society in turmoil, usually, and what's very positive about it is you want a cross current of ideas. You want ideas bashing heads like fucking rams, and when you have that, people are who where they're fighting for their souls with an idea, you're gonna get something pretty fucking cool. And you're going to get certainly very volatile artistic expression. And a lot of that expression can very well be Miles Davis, who was saying, I'm a black man in America with, you know, and I still don't feel free, or whatever it might be. Or you could have...
Bieber.
Bieber is candy compared to, think about it, how much music counted back then.
Right.
Jazz was the only place that a lot of black people could really express themselves honestly, through a fucking horn. So if your heart's broken, you either sing it or you shoot it through a horn, because if you say otherwise, you're gonna get fucking hung or shot or arrested. So things were way more extreme. And I think in today's world, where everything's at the touch of a button, where everybody has plenty to eat, even if it's not healthy food, and we feel safer. And I think we're cynical. I don't believe that what we do and what we say can really change the world. And back then you did.